Hello guys, welcome back to another episode of Biomedical Works. In this video, we will be discussing about ventilator. Please do subscribe the channel if you haven't subscribed yet. We have switched on the instrument and it has came to ready mode. Now we can connect the breathing circuit and a test lung for testing purpose. Before moving further, we should understand the basic purpose of a ventilator. Ventilator is a device that supports or takes over the breathing process, pumping air into the lungs. People who stay in intensive care units may need the support of a ventilator. These include people with severe COVID-19 symptoms. People require ventilation if they are experiencing respiratory failure. In such condition, a person cannot get enough oxygen and may not be able to expel carbon dioxide very well either. It can be a life-threatening condition. There are many injuries and conditions that can cause respiratory failure, including head injury, stroke, lung disease, spinal cord injury, sudden cardiac arrest, and pneumonia, etc. There are different types of ventilator, including non-invasive and invasive, that provide different levels of support. We know demand for ventilators has drastically increased due to COVID-19. Coronavirus attacks the respiratory system. When infected, a patient's ability to breathe is compromised. In mild cases, breathing or respiratory support can be provided using non-invasive method, such as delivering oxygen-rich air through a face mask. In more severe cases, an invasive form of respiratory support is required. This is provided through an artificial airway. A tube attached to a ventilator is inserted into the patient's mouth or nose or surgically made hole in the neck. Before connecting ventilator to a patient, it is mandatory to perform a pre-use checkup to ensure ventilator is working fine. We are starting the device check. We just need to follow the instructions given by the instrument. In this, we will be checking the alarm signals, auxiliary acoustic alarm, breathing circuit, humidifier, test lung connection, expiratory valve, safety valve, and expiratory flow sensor. Device check has completed. Now we will go to the breathing circuit check. For this, we need to remove the test lung and keep it closed at the end. The pre-use checkup procedure has successfully completed and ventilator is ready to use. We can see the green indication as the device check has passed. We have to set the application mode before using. Tube is for invasive ventilation and NIV for non-invasive ventilation. Now we can check the different options available in display. We can set the alarm limits here. Then we have ventilator settings. We can see the different ventilator modes here. Depends on the ventilator mode, we need to set O2 percentage, tidal volume, inspiratory time, respiratory rate, flow acceleration, Pmax, peep, etc. Then we have transfer data, for displaying all the measured and set values, the trend table. Then we have day or night option, and we can freeze the waveform. We have expiration hold option here. Then we have flow monitoring and auto calibration options here. Then we have system setup. We can adjust alarm volume and brightness here. Then we have key lock option. It locks all keys and buttons. This button is used to pause the audio for 2 minutes. Then we have alarm reset button. Then we have this option for suction procedure. Then we have nebulizer on or off switch. Then we have inspiratory hold switch. We can see inspiration is holder here. Then we have start or standby switch here.